Busy day today. So, Robert, what is next for Mikey Garcia?
I wish I knew, bro.
A lot of people were asking after the fight about Mikey and Gervonta Davis.
That'll be big, huge.
Why do you say that?
Because fucking Gervonta's a superstar, bro. Mikey's a good name, too. I think that's probably the biggest fight. Probably biggest fight that PBC could do, you know, between Gervonta and somebody else. Who else can he fight that would be that big? And if he moves up in weight to welterweight.
Well, Mayweather said he wants to keep on PBC side.
Right. So.
So what weight would they fight at? 40 or 47?
No, 140. But if it's at 140, who else can Gervonta Davis fight that would be huge?
From PBC, I don't know, but I know.
Yeah, that's what I mean. From PBC.
If he can fight anybody, if Ryan Garcia is a big fight at 35.
Be huge. Or.
Teofimo Loma. How does he do with those three?
I think he probably beats him, man. You know, my lightweight pound for pound, lightweight.
Yep.
I had Teofimo number one, Loma number two, Tang number three, and Ryan four, and
Devin
Haney five. Right? I think it changes now.
What made you change your mind? The way he fought, the patience, the power, he figured out the height, the distance.
I have to pick Haney number one, Tang number two, Teofimo three, Loma four, and Ryan five.
Who you had number one?
Devin Haney.
Why do you have him at number one?
Because if I don't pick him number one, I'm racist.
Oh, no, but that's take why. The racism part out
no,
of it.
No, he's number one. I got to pick him number one. People get mad at me. Right?
Yeah, people get mad at me all the time. But it's, forget that for a second. Based on boxing, based on skills.
One, so he's number one now.
Skill and power. Who do you have? One, two, three, four.
Skills, Loma. Skills, fucking Loma, number
okay.
one.
Power? Number
one. Power, Tank.
And then who's number two? After Tank.
Okay. Then Teofimo. Then Loma. And that might change too. If Loma fights with Teofimo, that might
it?
Change. Yeah. Might
yeah.
be Tank, Loma, and then the rest. Because Loma, I think Loma might be Teofimo in a rematch if they do the rematch.
Why do you say that? Because the way he looked?
You know what? Because of the way he looked. And, you know, I'm not taking that, I don't want to take anything away from Teofimo also, but from, I think Teofimo's fucking, yeah, you know, he's fucking badass. I think he's a fucking great, great fighter, great champion. But if we go to the fight, you know, when they fight the first six rounds, we all seen it. Loma just wasn't Loma. Like, I don't know, I'm not saying it wasn't Loma. He just didn't throw. And Teofimo won the rounds, but they were not dominant rounds where he was putting a beating on Loma either. And then the few rounds that Loma actually picked it up or turned it around, he did a little bit of damage. So I think if Loma does that for a whole 12 rounds, I think Loma could beat him. But it's also gonna be a rematch. So it's also gonna be Teofimo might fight different also. It's a very close fight, but I would probably lean towards Loma beating Teofimo in a rematch.
And Tank beats Josh Taylor, I've been telling people.
Man, you know what? I would probably think he does, but Josh Taylor is also a great fighter, man. He's a great counterpuncher.
Yeah. Smart fighter, southpaw.
Smart fighter, he's tall, he's southpaw, so that.
But can he take that power? Can he take that punishment?
Will he land? You know what I mean? He's too tough for Tank.
But so was Barrios.
Yeah, but Barrios is not as good as Barrios is not the same. Barrios, let's be real. Barrios is a great fighter.
Probably
great
it's warrior. Harder than Taylor.
Great warrior.
Yeah.
But I don't think he's in that level. You know, we seen the fight when he became champion. Remember?
Yep.
He took a beating in that fight. A lot of people thought he lost.
Okay,
actually.
What about
right?
this? Yeah.
All right then.
It's true. You know who called out Tank?
Oh.
Regis.
Regis did?
Yeah, what do you do about that fight?
Oh, Regis also wants, it would also be a good fight. Regis wants a big fight, and that's a huge fight, man.
And then,
there's so many fights out there, man, that I wish I could see, and I wish I could fucking talk fighters into make that fight happen, and that could make it easy. They could easily make it.
Teofimo's fighting Cambosis next. Who does Loma fight then?
Loma, hopefully the rematch with Teofimo.
But that means that's
well, Teofimo's fighting sports. August?
Yes.
So maybe
December.
They'll do it February, March, somewhere there. I think Loma will wait.
And
Loma wants that fight.
Bam didn't fight this weekend, right?
Oh, man,
what happened?
Sucks,
it's the
man.
Third. People won't fight him. He's too good, Robert.
Man, it wasn't even about the people this time, man. Honestly, This time, you know, the opponent was there. It was, the fight was ready to happen. It was just at 112, actually 113, and it was Mr. Honda that didn't want, because he says that's not his way. And I said, don't worry, we're gonna
he's
be
good
fine.
Enough, yeah.
He's good enough to fight. He said, no, you know, this guy's too big, and we're taking too much chance. We just don't worry about it.
Okay, does Bam still get paid if the guy
paid.
Misses?
Yeah, he got paid.
But he wants to fight.
Nah, but it's not about getting paid. He wants to fight.
Well, no, I'm saying at least yeah, you still got paid.
At least he got fined, but he wants to fight.
Because he made weight, is that the reason?
Yeah, he wants to fight.
Of course he wants, he trains. Yeah. And then tell me about Antonio Mireles.
Mireles. From what I
the Mexican Tyson Fury.
He's a good amateur, you know, a lot of, you know, he's huge, 6'8".
Tallest Mexican in the world of boxing, Robert.
Mexican-American, so we might have something there, you know.
Something's heavyweight.
His manager is really smart, you know. He's, you know,
pushing the right way.
Signed Topimo Lopez, so yeah. Smart man. So they signed him. And,
he's from Iowa,
yeah,
like Michael Nunn.
Let's see if we have Michael Nunn's from Iowa?
Isn't he? Isn't Michael Nunn from Iowa, Antonio?
Yeah.
Yeah, he is. And he, you know, when he trained, you told me there's no boxing culture. He didn't have a ring when he trained for the Olympics.
Michael Nunn, honestly.
No ring.
One of my favorite middleweights of all time. He was fucking badass.
You
man.
Know, he trained without a ring for the Olympics?
I didn't know that, but yeah. I know Michael Nunn from training with Goosen when I was a kid.
Yeah.
That fucker was fucking good. Fucking
shout out
fighter,
to him.
Man.
He just got out of jail. He did an MMA fight.
I wish I could fucking see him somewhere under. Hopefully he remembers me. Because I was just a kid, man.
I think I have his number. I could
I
call
was
him
like
afterwards.
10 or 12. I was like 10 or 12 when I was going to that gym, and he was fucking, his skills were fucking unbelievable, man. A lefty, sick, and I love his nickname. That's probably the best nickname ever.
Michael's second to none.
Second to, that's his nickname, second to. I think that's probably the best nickname ever.
Yeah, he was a great, he was pound for pound. He fought everybody, he beat everybody.
Second to none.
That's true, very cool.
I love that nickname.
And then, COVID over in Vegas, Robert?
What?
Is COVID over?
Yeah, it's over there. Well, they still tested those that don't have the vaccine. I have the vaccine, so I didn't have to test anymore. We didn't have to wear the mask anymore. Cool. So, but we're still in a certain bubble type.
But
still,
the whole world isn't.
We could go to the casino and eat. We got to take care of ourselves.
Just like everything.
Yeah.
But it's pretty much back to routine.
Yeah.
How many fans were at the fight? Sold out?
Well, I left right after my fight. I didn't even stay for the fight. At 7:30, I was already in the freeway. I got home at 10:30.
Wow, that's great.
Yeah, got home at 10:30. So I didn't even see the fight.
No one played them for you on the way?
No, well, I was, you know, all these guys through, we have a group message and everybody was texting, you know.
Yeah, the updates.
But I seen them, you know, the next day.
And then you had a shoot here for the last 2 days.
Yeah.
How was that? Jamel Herring?
Yeah, Jamel Herring. We had, Abner was going to be here too, but Abner was...
I know, I was with him in Atlanta.
We had, we started at 8 and finished at 6. 10 hours, it was tiring. Long.
But you know, in movies, it's really like that. They start 6 a.m. all the way to midnight. They shoot again and again and again, different angle. But it's good.